Imagine you're hosting your friends for dinner. And the aroma of your delectable pasta is making people almost drool. And as you're ready to serve your delicacy, you realize you don't have bread to serve it with. What do you do? Well, instant grocery delivery apps are at your rescue. From fruits and vegetables to birthday gifts, or even a PlayStation 5, these 10-minute delivery apps have become the game changers that have taken India's consumer market by storm. In a country where the local grocery stores or kiranas have reigned for generations, these apps are striving for a paradigm shift. Quick commerce apps promise to deliver everyday essentials in a mere 10 minutes or even less. Data suggests more and more Indians are getting hooked to these apps. According to Goldman Sachs, in April this year, quick delivery apps formed a $5 billion market. It captured around 45% of India's total online grocery market. Quick delivery apps are rapidly spreading their wings. Just a few years ago, they were confined to a couple of metros. But now, big players like Swiggy Instamart and Zomato's Blinkit operate in over 25 cities in India. But what's fueling this explosive growth of quick delivery apps? And in what ways are these apps reshaping India's retail landscape? Let's try to understand. Like every other online shopping business, online grocery firms saw a surge in demand during the COVID-19 pandemic. At the time, most e-commerce apps offered products either the next day or after a couple of hours, and there were only a handful of online grocery shopping apps. The lockdown led to a surge in demand for doorstep delivery of everyday goods, and that gave a massive push to these apps.
Especially in the current lockdown scenario, I don't have to step out of my house. I can get contactless delivery, and which I can pick up anytime I want, whenever I get free time from my work from home.
But that quickly died down as the pandemic waned. People started going out more and preferred physical shopping. And as demand for grocery apps declined, these apps were hit by a post-pandemic slump. Firms even had to resort to layoffs. Between 2022 and 2023, Swiggy Instamart reportedly laid off 380 employees. Blinkit dismissed around 120 people, and Dunzo cut around 300 jobs. But after the initial frenzy of physical shopping died down, people wanted to go back to convenience, and that led to a rebound in its demand. The post-pandemic slump was short-lived, and the popularity of quick grocery delivery apps was now skyrocketing again. Meanwhile, work from home and hybrid models left people nestled in their homes, further fueling their demand. The strong surge of India's quick commerce apps also lies in their business model. To ensure speedy deliveries, these firms set up small warehouses across cities where they operate. These warehouses are called dark stores. They're just like a supermarket. However, individual buyers can't go to these stores to directly purchase products. Condiments are reserved only for online deliveries. Today, major Indian cities have hundreds of such stores. According to the latest data, Swiggy Instamart has over 500 dark stores, followed by Zomato-owned Blinkit with 450. Meanwhile, Zepto operates around 340 dark stores across 10 cities. As per industry experts, the location of these stores is key for an app's success. Dark stores are set within a 3 to 4 kilometer radius of sizable high to mid-income population groups, which helps them deliver items in a timely manner.
जैसे कस्टमर ऑर्डर करता है सर, उसके बाद ऑर्डर कंपनी के पास जाता है, कंपनी यहाँ से यहाँ पर ऑर्डर बचता है, उसके बाद ये लोग रेडी करते हैं, उसके बाद हमारे मतलब जो हम लोग राइडर हैं उनको ढूंढते हैं, उसके बाद हमारे पास जैसे ऑर्डर टोकन बचता है, टोकन बजने के बाद हम पूरा ऑर्डर को प्रोसेस करते हैं, फिर उसके बाद हम ऑर्डर को डिलीवर करने जाते हैं कस्टमर की लोकेशन पर।
Data shows these quick commerce strategies have worked. Sales of quick commerce firms surged by over 230% from 2019 to 2022. And last year, their sales grew by 77%. Research says that quick commerce platforms are expected to grow their sales to over $3.1 billion by 2025. Quick commerce platforms have mastered the understanding of their target customers' purchase patterns. They are customizing services to cater to this experience, and that's bringing them massive revenues. While these billion-dollar valuations may seem glorious, not everything is hunky-dory with quick commerce platforms. Behind the scenes, there are massive challenges. Delivery partners, who are the backbone of this industry, often complain of poor work conditions and low incomes. This year, Blinkit delivery partners went on strike after the company changed its payment structure. Previously, Blinkit reportedly paid their delivery agents 50 rupees per order for weekend deliveries and around 30 rupees for each order on weekdays. However, in April, Blinkit reclassified Saturdays as weekdays. That meant a significant decrease in their weekend earnings.
Din mein sir wohi order ke piche 15-20 rupees milta hai. Din mein sir wohi 15-20 order kar pata hu din mein. 4-5 kilometer ke range mein jana padta hai.
Further, the promises of quick delivery come with massive penalties for the delivery agents. For each order that isn't delivered on the specified time frame, the app punishes agents by cutting their minimum weekly wage. This can range from 15% to 20% of their wages and forces workers to resort to dangerous means to meet the deadlines. As quick commerce continues to reshape India's retail landscape, on one side, we see the promise of convenience and on the other, the challenges. All this as traditional retail shops fight for their existence.